Hello, welcome to Just Learn Civil. This video tutorial covers the basic of the MATLAB. Let's begin. This is the command window where we write our command. This is the workspace where the created variable appears. Let's start by creating some variables. Suppose I assign value x equals to 2 and press enter. Then we get our created variable the workspace as here. X equals to 2. Again, I create y equals to 5. You can see y appears in the workspace with its value. Now, if I have to clear the command window, then I will type clc enter. This will clear only the command window, not the workspace. If you want to clear workspace, then clear clear. And if you want to clear only x value, then type x enter. You can see here x is gone. Suppose I create again. Now I want to clear all the workspace at once. Then I will type clear clear all. This will clear everything within the workspace. I assigned x equals to 2, so it appears here. If I assign nothing, only I press 5, then by default it will be assigned to a variable named ans. Now you can see here the formatting is too loose. If we want compact formatting, then we do format compact. Now if I type z equals to 2, it uses less space. If I need again that loose format, then I will type format. Now I type y equals to 3. You can get the loose format. You can work on any format. Now I will use compact format. MATLAB stands for Matrix Laboratory. We can perform here mathematical calculations, matrix calculations, solve equation, differential equation, simultaneous equation, also write codes using function. Let's see how mathematical calculations are done. Suppose I type x plus 5. Can you guess what would be the answer? You can see here the value of x is 2, so it will be x plus 5 equals to 2 plus 5 equals to 7. As I didn't assign anything, it was stored in a variable, default variable. If I assigned sum equals to, then we will get sum as 7. You can do addition, subtraction, like x into 2, or multiplication, you get 4. You can use it as calculator. Suppose I want to type some code in one line and continue it in another line, then you can do it by 2 into and then pressing 3 dots, then enter, and 2 into, if I suppose type z or say y, then I would get answer. I know the value of y is 3, then 3 into 2, 6. The variable appears in the workspace. This is same as doing multiply 1 equals to 2 into y. You get the same answer. 3 dot means just continuing the statement in another line. If the statement is big, 3 dots can be used. Now let's see how we can go to the history. Let's type x into y plus. This is a random expression. Suppose I need to do correction in this line, then I would go in history by pressing the up arrow key in the keyboard. You can navigate it to the history. Using the up and arrow key, you can move up and down, and if you want this command to appear, then you can press the right arrow key and do correction. If you want help on any command, you can sort help format. You will get everything on format, how the format command works. So you can search it here, or you can also search here in the documentation. Now I will clear workspace. I entered 5 by 2, it is 2.5. Now I want the answer in fraction, then you can do sym 5 by 2. Here you get answer in fraction. If you get answer in format e plus 3 or something like that, then you can do format bank. I have already done format bank, so my answer appears this way. So this is all we learned today in the first tutorial. How to clear screen, how to clear workspace or only variable of workspace, then how to create variables, how to do mathematical operations on variables, how to continue it in next line, how to format loose, compact, long, how to get help from the MATLAB on any command, and how to display the result in decimal or fraction. Command history by pressing the up arrow key. So this is all we learned in the first tutorial. In the next tutorial, we will be dealing further tutorials on MATLAB, like matrix operations and others. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for updates.